Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Shweta and I welcome you to Teaching Learning with Shweta. So after a long time, I'm back to studies. So this is another lecture that I'm going to add to the lecture series Research Methodology. It's on Inductive and Deductive Reasoning. We are still on the initial phase of understanding what research means and the logic that we use and the philosophy in research. So this is, it's very important to understand inductive and deductive reasoning because we usually apply these in all kinds of researches. So it's basically a part of philosophy, the topic logic, but then we apply these logics in research as well. So in any research methodology book, you will always find an introduction on inductive and deductive reasoning. तो बहुत दिन हो गए थे पढ़ाई नहीं की है बट देन प्रॉमिस किया है तो मुझे वो निभाना है सो आई हैव टू कंप्लीट दिस लेक्चर सीरीज ऑन रिसर्च मेथोडोलॉजी सो लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड सो वी स्टार्ट विद डिडक्टिव रीजनिंग तो डिडक्टिव रीजनिंग क्या होता है व्हेन वी आर मूविंग फ्रॉम समथिंग जनरल टू स्पेसिफिक वी आर अराइविंग एट अ कंक्लूजन फ्रॉम वी आर बेसिकली टेकिंग एन एग्जाम्पल एंड वी आर कंपेयरिंग इट टू समथिंग दैट हैज ऑलरेडी बीन एस्टैब्लिश्ड एंड देन वी आर अराइविंग एट अ कंक्लूजन अबाउट दैट पर्टिकुलर एग्जाम्पल So, and that general theory against which we are comparing that example, जैसे कोई अगर कोई general theory है किसी भी community के बारे में और एक इंसान है उस community को belong करता है तो उसको हम compare कर रहे हैं तो मतलब हम एक general theory जो है उससे हम एक case को compare करें एक example को compare करें so we are basically we are analyzing one particular case against a general theory That has been established. ये जो general theory है ये कोई ऐसी vague theory नहीं होती it's a tried and generally a tried and tested and experimented formulated theory. So we are moving from that general to a specific conclusion about a case. So we start with the theory, we compare the example to the theory and then we confirm and conclude. So the first statement with the general statement is a major premise which for example all dogs bark. And Tommy, which is one particular case, one example, also barks. Hence, Tommy is a dog. So all dogs bark is a major premise here, and Tommy barks is a minor premise, and or the example and the conclusion that we arrive is that Tommy is a dog. So it's a general from the general theory with the general statement that all dogs bark. We arrive to a conclusion that Tommy, who might be in front of us, that particular case, that particular creature is a dog. So this is how we move from general to specific in deduction. So in deduction, the purpose is to arrive at a conclusion about that particular example. Now here, the major premise always has to be true. And it is not a random statement or a random thing that we have observed. It's generally something that already has been researched and established and is popular. And accepted widely. So when we move from that, so we are comparing against that widely accepted or tested and tried statement, and then we are coming to this conclusion about one particular case that we are comparing. Deductive reasoning was given by Aristotle, and hence in all the books you will always find this example, especially in the philosophy books that talk about deductive reasoning. All men are mortal. It's a major premise. Socrates is a man, and That's the minor premise, and including the example that we want to prove or get a conclusion about, and hence Socrates is mortal. That's the conclusion. So this is an example of a very famous example of deductive reasoning. Then we have another example. If we think we exist, that is given by Descartes, and I think that's a very popular, a very famous statement given by Descartes. You will see the statement in the status, the WhatsApp status of many people also. So basically this line that he had used, he had not randomly used it. He had arrived at this conclusion after diving really deep into so many theories and doing a lot of experiments and doing a lot of research. So he came, so this can be treated as a general statement, you know, something, an established statement. It's not a vague statement that he gave. So if we think we exist, and I of course think, so I think, hence I think. So it's a top-down approach. When you are moving from a general thing, a general theory, to a specific conclusion about a specific example, compared against that theory. So it's a top-down approach. Now, deductive reasoning may also end up with some errors. For example, if we use a general statement, good students always pass the exams. I don't understand this concept, though, good students, but then I've heard people saying this a lot, good students, bad students. So students who work hard, students who are disciplined, students who are consistent with their studies. This is what we mean by good here. Good students always pass exam. Reena is good, so she will pass. Okay. This is also deductive reasoning. But here, if Reena doesn't pass the exam by chance, if Reena fails, then that means any of the two premises, the major and the minor one, is false. And we need to check with it. So obviously, as I had said, that the major premise is always tested, usually attested, verified, and a general statement, a general accepted theory. So it needs to be correct always. So good students always pass the exam is not necessarily always correct. Because Reena, certainly being good, she did not pass the exam. So either the minor premise here is wrong, either Reena is not good, or the fact that the major premise that good students pass the exam is not true. So we need to check with these two premises too, because we've certainly arrived at a wrong conclusion. Instead of passing, she failed. So there can be errors in deductive reasoning too, but we need to know that deductive reasoning, the purpose of deductive reasoning is to arrive at a conclusion. Then we talk about inductive reasoning. Inductive reasoning is based upon empiricism. Empiricism kya hota hai? Hamare khud ke experiences, jo hum observe karte hain, jo hum dekhte hain, sunte hain, samajhte hain, khate hain, peete hain, aur feel karte hain, wo sab kya hamare experiences hain. To experiences pe based, jab kuch hum theory banate hain, ya kuch hum hypothesis banate hain, ya koi assumption banate hain, ya thinking form karte hain. That is experiencing something, or that is basically empiricism. So it is also based on empiricism. That is several observations made and arriving at a conclusion based on those observations. So here we are not choosing a statement which is a generalized statement already arrived after experimentation or testing, but here we are making a guess, hypothesizing something. We are thinking, we are making a hypothesis based on our own observations. Ki humne aisa dekha, ki is sadak par bahut accidents hote hain. Ye hamara anubhav hai, ye humne dekha hai. So this is empiricism. We are making observations and we are forming a hypothesis ki is sadak par hi sabse zyada accidents hote hain. So this is how we make a hypothesis, and that may or may not be correct, right? So this is basically, we are making a general statement using the examples that we have seen. Wahan deduction mein hum general statement se apne example ko compare kar rahe the. We were comparing an example with a general statement already given after experimentation, the theory that is already established. We are comparing the example with that theory. Here we are forming, we are taking examples, and based on those examples that we have observed, we are forming a theory. So here it's a bottom-up approach. There we were moving from a general theory to one specific conclusion about a case. Here we are taking several cases, and then based on those cases we are forming theory. So this is this is just opposite to deduction. For example, this particular medicine nauseates me, and nausea means allergy. So definitely I am allergic to this medicine. So nobody should take this medicine. So this is a general statement I made on the basis of this medicine. 100 times I took this medicine, 100 times I felt nauseated. So this medicine is causing allergy. So here we took several examples of those similar kind of medicines, and hence we arrived at a general statement that all such medicines cause nausea, they shouldn't be taken. So in deduction, we were arriving at an example from a general thing. Here we are taking examples and arriving at a general theory. So the major premise here is that the medicine nauseates me. Several medicines we will take of this kind, and there will be several major premises, and from that we can the minor premise is that nausea means allergy, so these medicines cause allergy. That's the conclusion, and here the conclusion is leading to a theory, a hypothesis. Okay, now this may or may not be correct. This again is subject to testing and verification. So induction never gives a definite conclusion. The theory or the hypothesis that it forms may be incorrect. So there are more chances of error in induction. Because induction, the purpose of induction is not to arrive at a conclusion about a single case, but give a general theory from different cases. Now by chance, if all those cases are wrong, then our theory will also be wrong. By chance, I took all the expired medicines, not the good medicines, but all the expired medicines. I took 50 such medicines that caused me nausea, and I arrived at a conclusion that this brand is bad. It shouldn't be bought. Here I arrived at a wrong theory because all the examples, all the cases of medicines that I took, they were expired. So induction only leads to a hypothesis, a probable case, a probable theory, okay, which is subject to further testing. But it never leads to a definite conclusion that that deduction does. So there are more chances of error in induction, and the purpose of induction is to form a hypothesis or a general theory subject to testing. But it is actually based on our own observations. We observed, we experienced something, we experienced a few things, and on the basis of those few particular examples, we are making a hypothesis. So those particular cases that we take, that's basically sampling. So research mein bhi hum yahi karte hain, hum 50 logon se baat karte hain. Agar hum sirf ek se baat kare aur bol dein ki ye community ke log aise hote hain, to wo to bilkul hi galat theory ho jayegi, fir koi manega nahi. आप 50 लोगों से बात करेंगे तो मतलब आपने ज्यादा से ज्यादा एग्जांपल्स को आपने कवर किया, फिर आपकी बात में दम होगा कि हाँ 50 में से 40 लोग ऐसे निकले, ऐसे बोल रहे हैं, तो उसमें दम है. तो जितने ज्यादा आप सैंपल लोगे, जितने ज्यादा एग्जांपल्स दोगे, उतनी ज्यादा जो आपका कंक्लूजन निकल रहा है वो और वैलिड होता जाएगा. तो दिस इज बेसिकली इंडक्शन. तो आप बहुत सारे एग्जाम्पल्स लोगे तो चांसेस हैं कि आपका कंक्लूजन करेक्ट होने की तरफ जाएगा. So, specific to general, we take examples and then we move to formulation of hypothesis, subject to further testing. So that is inductive reasoning. Now, there are problems like I have told you. Sun rises early morning. Now, we have all seen that the sun comes out in the morning. Sun rises in the morning. Because I have seen that always. It's not that it's written somewhere that sun rises early morning. Because in Alaska, if you ask people, they don't see the sun early morning. So the sun does not rise in Alaska in the early morning. So here the conclusion that we are arriving at, that sun always rises, it's not necessarily true for everyone. So that's the problem of induction. The major premise may be wrong if you are considering the wrong cases or only the chosen or the biased cases. That was given by David Hume. So wrong major premise, wrong minor premise, or faulty observations, wrong sampling, biased sampling can result in errors in conclusion of the induction. So what are the goals? To sum it up, deduction leads to certainty or conclusion. It's more certain because we are talking about one or two cases and comparing against an established theory. Okay, and in induction, we are taking several examples and then arriving at a hypothesis or a conclusion. The conclusion is still probable. It is still not final. It is not still, we are not sure that it is 100% applicable to the entire world, because in induction, the first step is taking examples, and we have not covered all the examples in the world. So therefore, there is always a chance of that the conclusion being false. Now, research keeps employing both induction and deduction. When we are starting with observing things and forming hypothesis, which is what we do in research, then this is induction. And then we arrive at a hypothesis and we begin to test it. To test the hypothesis, we take several examples, okay? And then we arrive at conclusion. So that's again deduction. So we are using induction, deduction both continuously off and on in our research. So induction and deduction, they are kinds of reasoning, and we constantly employ them in our real lives in research. And as a research scholar, it is very important for you to know the difference between the two. So that's about inductive and deductive reasoning. Thank you. Have a nice day. And do subscribe my channel. Thank you.